Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube show Health Cue, the place to be where our aim is to boost up your health motivation, to boost up that health morale so that you can look at the brighter side of your health problem and start taking a proactive stance towards it, start working towards it and get a better living. Coming to today's topic, we are going to talk about Botox therapy as an option of management of cerebral palsy. Coming up. But before moving ahead, do ensure you subscribe to my channel so that you can get notified every single time I upload a new video. So don't forget to hit that bell icon as well so that you can get that notification. And for this video, I would like to give a special thanks to Dr. Shivam Mittal, consultant neurologist at Vikram Hospitals, Bangalore. Because whatever content that you're going to see in today's video has been contributed by him. We actually went and shot his film. We wanted that he gets featured into this video and deliver the entire information, but unfortunately due to some technical errors we were not able to take his audio clips properly and it is not well audible. That's the reason I'm going to just say his part, but all the information that is mentioned in this video has been delivered by him. So again, thank you so much Dr. Shivam Mittal for giving this valuable insights. Botulinum A toxin or Botox is an injectable drug that's made out of a toxic substance that's found in the bacteria Clostridium botulinum. Botox is an extremely toxic substance, but when applied in a smaller dose and is injected locally, has been approved for use for medical as well as cosmetic reasons. Hence, when it is applied on the muscles that are too spastic or too tight, it actually reduces the levels of spasticity and make it much more relaxed. One of the most common symptoms following cerebral palsy is stiffness and spasticity. Children living with cerebral palsy often experience this impairment of movement that happens due to spasticity. Botox works by weakening or paralyzing the muscles into which it is injected. Basically, what it does, it blocks the nerves from its firing. Although this effect of Botox is a temporary one, eventually it wears off. Hence, when it is applied on the muscles that are too spastic or too tight, it actually reduces the levels of spasticity and make it much more relaxed. A patient suffering from spasticity find way too difficult to move independently, to sit independently, to walk independently, and to do some basic activities with the help of his hand. But when Botox is applied, these tasks become easier since the muscles are relaxed. Since Botox is known to reduce the overactive firing of the nerves of the spastic muscles, when applied, helps in improving the gross motor functions of the patient. Gross motor functions basically involves the overall activities like standing, walking, lifting some objects and doing some basic tasks like carrying something, holding something, throwing something like that, which is way more difficult for a child or a person suffering from cerebral palsy. Unfortunately, all these effects are temporary. The effect of Botox weans off gradually. Hence, it's not a permanent solution for management of spasticity, but is safe enough when applied with the help of skilled and experienced professionals, and is one of the most commonest choice of treatment for spasticity management by doctors across the world. So friends, this was a small info about cerebral palsy management with the help of Botox therapy. I hope you find this video useful. To ensure, you mention your feedbacks, your thoughts and your comments in the comment section below. And on that note, see you next week. Bye bye.